All right, so now's where the fun begins. Let's take a number like we just did, that 1 1 0 1 0 1, and let's convert that. So that's a base 2 number, and we want to convert that to see what is that in decimal. When we're converting between these bases, there's no shorthand, right? 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is not 10. 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. We can't, there's no equivalency there between the two, and so we just have to go through and convert these based on the positional value of each digit. So again, we'll do this kind of large down here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits. Okay? And remember that each, in order to calculate, just like we do in decimal, and say that this is a, you know, this is the spot that's 10 to the 0, so this is the 1 spot, this is 10 to the 1, so this is the 10 spot, this is 10 to the 2, so that's the 100 spot. You know this intuitively because you've done it for so long that if you get a number like this, you know right off the bat that's 100,000. Wow, sorry. I don't know how to fix it. You know right off the bat that that's 100,000 in decimal. But we go through that same process in hexadecimal or binary, and it's confusing to you because it's new. Well, let's make it more intuitive by practicing with it. So we get 1 1 0 1 again. This is back to our same problem. Base 2, and we want to know what that is in base 10. Okay, so we get back to our same 6 spots, and we say we know the base that we're in is 2, and so that's what we're going to do here for our math. We're going to say 2, and then what's the position? Well, we start at 0 according to the decimal place. So if you picture a number, all numbers are going to have a decimal place. We either have zeros on this side or not, but anything to the left of this is a 0, and then if we go to this side, it's going to end up being 2 to the negative 1, 2 to the negative 2, and so on. But on this side, scratch that for a minute. On this side, we're going to have 2 to the 0, 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2, 2 to the 3, 2 to the 4, 2 to the 5. Okay? And it's really easy in binary again because 2 to the 0 is always going to be 1. Any number to the power of 0 is 1. 2 to the 1 is going to be 2. 4, it's always just going to be doubled. 8, 16, 32. And what I'm saying is I have a 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So what do I have? I have a 32 and a 16 and a 4 and a 1. Let's add those up. So 6 plus 2 is 8, plus 4 is 12, 13. Carry the 1. We got 5. So this is a 53 in decimal. Okay? And what eventually will likely happen is that you'll start to kind of do this in your head. You'll say 32 plus 16 plus 4 plus 1. But until you do that, you can do it this way. We just say which of these switches is turned on and then add those numbers in. If it's a 0, it doesn't count. But if it's a 1, we have 1 32, we have 1 16, we have 1 4, and we have 1 1. And actually, if we wanted to write it out a little better, we could say we have, scratch that, we have 1 times 32, we have 1 times 16, we have 0 times 8, we have 1 times 4, we have 0 times 2, and we have 1 times 1, and then we could go through and do the actual math. So this is a 32, this is a 16, that's a 0, that's a 4, that's a 0, and that's a 1, and then add it together, and it's still going to come out to be 53. But that's how we do it. Let's do one more just to practice. So if I get a number, I'll just start writing ones and zeros. Okay. And I say, what's that number in base 10? Again, I can just go ones, twos, fours, eights, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. So I have 1, 256 plus a 64. Okay, so 260 plus 60 is 320. 352. And 356, 357. Okay, or I can go through the, if that doesn't work for me, I can go through the more manual process and say I have 1, 256. I have 0, 128s, 164, and add them together. So let me check my math on this. Well, we don't need to. We'll do it the old-fashioned way. So we got a 256 plus a 64 plus a 32 plus a 4 plus a 1. Why didn't you tell me it wasn't typing? That's embarrassing. I'm sitting here typing the whole time. My num lock was on. I was not focused on it. Anyway, okay, 1. Oh, no, what am I doing? 256 plus 64. Have you ever seen those people who are really good with the 10 keypad? It's amazing to watch them do it. I wish I was that good. 32, 4 plus 1 equals 357. Okay. Should have trusted my brain. All right, so that's how we convert from binary to decimal. Let's try converting now from hex to decimal in the next video. The suspense is killing you. Spencer, out.